us today, as always, art knows no national boundaries. Genius can speak in any tongue, and the entire world will hear it and listen. Behind the storm of daily conflict and crisis, the dramatic confrontations, the tumult of political struggle, the poet, the artist, the musician, continues the quiet work of centuries, building bridges of experience between peoples, reminding man of the universality of his feelings and desires and despairs, and reminding him that the forces that unite are deeper than those that divide. Thus art, and the encouragement of art, is political in the most profound sense, not as a weapon in the struggle, but as an instrument of understanding of the futility of struggle between those who share man's fate. Aeschylus and Plato are remembered today, long after the triumphs of imperial Athens are gone. Dante outlived the ambitions of 13th century Florence. Goethe stands serenely above the politics of Germany. And I am certain that after the dust of centuries has passed over our cities, we too will be remembered, not for victories or defeats in battle or in politics, but for our contribution to the human spirit.
We shall now see and hear through the magic of tape your master and mine and every musician's master, Casals, conducting two movements from Bach's third suite in D, the famous Air and the Gigue.
This is called Lines Written in dejection on the eve of great success. It's a very cautious title. I once had a cow that jumped over the moon. Not onto the moon, but over. I don't know what made her so lunar alone. All she'd been having was clover. That was back in the days of my godmother Goose. But though we are goosier now, and all tanked up with mineral juice, we haven't caught up with my cow.
It was wonderful.